Horace Pippin painted about 140 works all told, so not many. He's known for several themes. He did some history paintings, some religious paintings. One of his most respected themes are these interior scenes of his memories as a child, and certainly Sunday Morning Breakfast is one of those works. There are about 10 in the series or in that group of works. This is a wonderful one in that sense. You have a very simple story, very, very compellingly told. We're up very close to the family. We sort of feel like we're in this single room with them. The woman is serving this wonderfully steaming plate of breakfast to the two kids who are looking at her waiting for their breakfast. The warmth of the stove and the kettle, which has steam coming out of it, so it's on boil. It just creates this really wonderful warmth. The gentleman over here who's taking his shoes off to join for breakfast, or possibly maybe he's already had his breakfast and he's going out to work. But the simplicity of the story and the clarity of it and the warmth of it is really one of the most compelling images, I think. And one of the things that Pippin is really, really wonderfully known for. I think the other element that Pippin is known for that this work sort of exemplifies is this wonderful, sophisticated modernist eye. He was showing with some of the best American modernists, academically trained modernists at the time, and he clearly has the sensibility to sort of engage in this and have a wonderful dialogue with his own very sophisticated visual sensibility. So we see these reduced forms in the background, the rectangle of the door and the window and the cupboard, the very simple colors. It sort of locks everything into place and quiets everything down so we can really enjoy this, really, you know, this simple gesture of the woman's hand reaching out to the children. These flat patterns of the rag rugs, which are, you know, ubiquitous in homes when Pippin was growing up. The checkered pattern of the woman's apron that's very flat and very modernist and reads really wonderfully bold against this very simple story. So I think this is a particular work that is masterful for its merging of this wonderful, compelling narrative and yet this very sophisticated, reduced geometric order that we think of as high modernism.